Okay, well, you ready to go?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, so all we know is that this is a what? You puzzle your way out of rooms?
I mean, as far as I know, this game is entirely about having tea time in creepy mansions and getting to know each other on a deep and personal level.
This is why you're not a research man for the podcast.
Oh my god, I'm inside you. And okay. It's terrifying.
That's fine. You're a weird shadow man.
Do you actually... Oh!
Wait, you're a weird shadow... What?
Act 1, the entrance hall. So welcome everybody, this is Keith. I'm here with Wanderbot. We're playing sort of a room escape game, but in reverse, in that we're trying to break into a house, basically. That sounds way worse than I meant for it to. But,
Well, yeah, it's a
puzzle exploration game.
Yeah. Okay, does the note say anything? Okay.
Yeah.
Dear Mr. Gladsbury, condolences on the loss of your grandfather. As realtor of the estate and notary of Sir Edmund Gladsbury's will, it is my duty to welcome you to the Gladsbury estate. I apologize for not receiving you in person. It was the wish of your grandfather that you would be inspecting the house for an hour before my arrival. I can only assume that the house might hold some valuables you wish to keep out of the will. This is not as uncommon as it sounds, and as always, I will respect the will as it is written. Regards, Simon Renwell, legal attorney. So he's giving us free access to loot the shit out of this place, assuming we can find things worth looting.
An old and tarnished photo, but what did it have
Simon
on it?
Simon Renwell, attorney at law.
Hey, Keith, I found a thing.
Where are you? We should probably stick very close together, here. Or we'll immediately be confused about our combined knowledge.
So it looks like it's just four letters.
Oh, we need a code. Don't brute force it.
I'm not brute forcing.
You solve puzzles. Oh, there's a note directly behind you.
There's only a certain. I was gonna switch it so it said butts.
Right behind us, it says. The dark knight flies, a many-hued phantom. It soars and spreads its wings above the gloomy human crowd. The whole world calls to it. The whole world implores it. Wait. So in the dark night sky is a many-hued phantom. I think it's a crow. Soars and spreads its wings above the gloomy human crowd. The whole world calls to it.
Why a crow?
Oh, sorry. I mean, a many-hued phantom, swords, rings. Oh, maybe it would be
sunrise.
Like,
it's moon.
Moon? Is it a many-hued?
Oh, it has the right number of letters.
Because it changes colors,
like
the red moon.
No, it's not moon. It's not moon.
Oh, because there's no O.
Yeah, I've got a limited number of things to pull from.
Oh, hey, but there's no O in the third slot.
What if it doesn't even match up with
crumb.
That code?
I mean, it's right across the way.
Yeah, my assumption is they're directly next to it. Oh, do you have a flashlight? I mean, I have a zoom in on
Keith's
shadowy
mouse. We don't have a settings menu, so I don't know what our controls are.
Yeah, I have start over and quit to main menu.
Okay, let's look at the statue.
Okay.
So he's missing his right arm.
He's also missing a willy.
It's covered by the fabric, silly.
I will suss out this willy.
So there's another statue in the middle of the room, like the very middle of the room where we first started, and right in front of that there's another
statue.
Another code here. It says 2.
By the way,
10 fish I caught without an eye and 9 without a tail. Half of 8 and 6 missing heads landed in my pail. Who can tell me, as I ask it, how many fish are in my basket? What?
Oh, okay. So you have to match all the pieces together.
I think
together.
What we should do is actually we should run around all over the place. Is that a thing on the bottom?
What are you trying
to do? That's just an issue. So if you press spacebar, you actually get to see all of the clues that you picked
up.
Oh,
that's
useful, yeah. So what we might want to do is actually run around and grab all of them.
Wait.
Can you press spacebar and tell me
riddle
if you
number
have
one.
The... Well, I just found it. But can you tell me, press spacebar, do you have statue one clue?
I'm happy
you
now.
You have light.
How did you turn that on?
There's a lantern on the floor and I picked it up. It was right where
you
I started.
You picked up the lantern.
Well, so I'm jealous because it's dark as shit. But anyway, can you press spacebar and tell me if you have...
Did you read this?
I know, Keith.
A plate of old-timey confections, almost super glue.
To the paint. Okay, press spacebar, tell me if you have the statue one clue.
No, just 2 and 3.
Okay, it's in here. I didn't know if the notes were... No, in this cabinet here.
In the cabinet.
Sorry, I was just noticing this weird stuff under that couch there.
Yeah.
Oh, hey,
so
look!
So, password number one, or riddle number one, first we met the Baron at his throne and bowed
that's
as he
sequence.
Should. They gave one letter each, positions carved in wood. Let's see.
Welcome, child. Welcome to my mansion. Now, no doubt, you are here looking for your inheritance, but I have other plans for now. Having observed the rotten roots of my family tree as I grew closer to old age, I realized that none of you deserve a single penny from me, and I don't believe death is enough reason for me to suddenly change my attitude. That is why I remade this place, as a test. I have filled the halls with riddles and puzzles, and it is up to you to solve them to prove to me that you deserve my wealth. If you do not solve them in a timely manner, charges across, the cellars will ignite, and the whole place burns to the ground. So go ahead. Let me see you being worthy of my name, or at least help me trim the family tree of some rotten branches. Hey, no, no, go back. Go back to that letter. There were some typos in it. So
the typos
notice
are code.
The one I, what, notice the one I in the middle that is lowercase and how there's two periods at the end. I'm trying to figure out other...
There was it's another. An there's actually another one stashed behind this couch here. Two. What number do you get? What number do you get when you multiply all of the numbers on a telephone number's pad?
Zero, because zero is always the last one.
Oh, you're right. It's really easy. We just need to find the. Right? Oh, what was Z in the first slot on this guy? Let's find out.
Oh, hey.
I don't see a Z. I'm going to say no, Z is not here, unless
wait,
null is an answer.
What were you doing with the clock?
I don't think N is on
here
either.
What's that ticking?
That's Keith flipping switches. This game is interesting, but it's not actually well made.
That was just me, Pap. I was flipping through the letters,
but,
yeah.
But like, we could hear it from
no,
the
no.
opposite
go
side
back
of the room.
To the,
you
to
can
that
open
panel
drawers.
On that side. Is it another?
Yeah, we got another one of these flippy things.
All these drawers are empty. So you found another code. Where'd you go?
Yeah, over here on the left
side
of the room.
Hey, so shouldn't one be zero? Like, can you put
in so.
Zero?
Oh, another. We have another secret here. So clue number one, seek me out among the art, found below the frame of a heart. Down to knees the seeker fell, if he wishes to do well. So we need to go
these
in front of
a... These are sorted into different things.
So if we go into
we
a frame of
a
frame heart,
with
if
the
we
heart?
Crouch, I think we'll find something. Let's look for
right,
paintings.
Need... Hey.
That's some pretty impressive underboobage. Okay.
I'm going to run around a little bit and see if I can find a painting that looks like it's of a heart or of love.
That one thing answer was zero, but I don't know where it, what it goes to.
Yeah, that's the question.
The other question is...
Oh. Tab takes my lantern
so
in and out. I don't know if that helps you at all, though.
At the same time.
No. You can turn on lamps, by the way, as you go by.
Oh, interesting. Like,
you can
They're called riddles and clues.
Wait, they're both missing an eye?
Yeah.
And they have a lion on a plate?
Yeah, the problem is, like, we haven't played this enough to actually get, like, an idea of what matters.
Oh, yeah, I'm resigned to probably failing our first attempt because of the time limit, but just learning what to expect of the game as we go.
See, look, is that... It's a crow, and there's...
A key. Probably doesn't matter.
Oh, do you need a lamp just to see the titles? Venom.
Did you try picking up the other light?
Keith.
There's another light, too. I don't know if you can pick it up.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Or I think it just turns on and off, actually.
Three statues, three riddles, three words. I set them together to make sure that everything you see and touch is connected. You must understand I wish for you to succeed. Even the dead can be disappointed. Everything you need is in this room. Everything you will need will be in every room.
So I'm finding more and more of those weird sequences where it shows five squares and different ones are lit up. They're even hidden inside of drawers.
Huh.
President Carter pardons Vietnam War draft evaders.
I can't imagine. I feel like a lot of the flavor texty things. Oh yeah, I just found another one of those too.
Yep.
I feel like the flavor texty things are just flavor text.
So, at dawn. Hey.
No. We're gonna get together right now. I'm finding clues. Then we're gonna get together and read them.
Hmm.
I'm also gonna turn on every light available.
Well, can we go read the title? Close enough to the light?
Cozen.
Cozen.
Yeah.
Some nice artwork in this game. Granted, it's often open source or something, or royalty free with games like these.
Visually, it ain't bad.
I can't leave now. Just keep calm.
Oh.
Okay. Find something?
I'm noticing that all of the different paintings have codes under them.
Yeah, we ran into that earlier.
Well, the titles. No, go look at the framed pieces. I mean, I want to see what they are.
If I find one of the heart,
you have to look.
It says that if you go to your knees, you'll find what you need or whatever when you find the painting with the heart. And so they're talking about the code that's on the ground. Let's see. For three, it says, at dawn, the phantom vanishes to be reborn in every heart. And every night, it is born anew, and every day it dies.
Wait, can you read that again?
That was the one upstairs.
At dawn, the phantom vanishes to be reborn in every heart. And every night, it's born anew, and every day it dies. So it probably is the moon.
Yeah, that one could be the moon.
Because that's still three, which is the same number as the one you thought was the moon before. We should try typing Luna into the moon one as an alternate entry for moon. I just jumped down this. Nope. I tried to jump off the balcony.
Yeah, I know. I was hoping there would be a jump, but instead it just gives you the your notes, and it's like,
oh, this one explains this whole area around us. Three statues, three riddles, three words. I set them together to make sure that everything you see and touch is connected. You must understand, I wish for you to succeed. Even the dead can be disappointed. Everything you need is in this room. Everything you will need will be in every room. I realized halfway through that that's what you read earlier.
Yes.
I didn't hear the first two lines when you started reading it the first time, but I definitely remember the rest of it.
Yep.
A lot of headlines about this person dying. Why is there newspapers about the death of this guy in his own house?
I don't know.
Dun, dun, okay. Dun. There's a throne.
That doesn't even make sense.
Have we had a throne name yet?
Yeah, Keith, can you come over so that we can see? So, Kitchen Kaon.
I just want to say, did we have a throne mentioned in one of these clues?
Here, Keith, come
first
over to this painting.
Baron at his throne and bowed his head.
The lady.
They gave one letter each position's carved in wood.
I just need your
wood. No, I'm saying I think KCZHN is the answer. Might be the answer to because it's the throne. This might be the answer to statue number one.
Oh, he's missing his right arm.
Because it says to bow your head at the throne.
Prion,
the lady.
And Venom.
Okay, yeah, just wanted to see what those said. Did you see the square thing over here? By the way, you can sprint. I don't know if you know.
KCZHN. Oh. There's not a ton of reason to, though.
Hey, Keith. You know those squares? Those squares probably relate to,
Are they parts of the titles?
Yeah, so these squares here are parts of the titles along the way.
Wait, how many of them are there? Go back.
There's five letters, but there's only four bits, which corresponds with...
Right, so... Here, this is one of those games where I really want a notepad.
Keith, wait. You with the light source...
I think I found zero. Got it.
Hey, I heard
zero
it.
Zero was the weird and elf wizard in the middle. There's actually a weird pedestal here that has. Yeah, I just saw that.
Yeah, so
we found zero.
Okay.
So this is statue.
Well, we found
one?
Only two of those.
No, statue two was the zero. Yeah. So we solved statue two.
Okay.
So there's a statue two.
So we got to figure out which one of these like typey things can spell moon.
No! You guys are missing it. Go back to the titles of the paintings, please.
Yeah, so Keith, we need your light source for a second. Stop flipping. You're the only one with a light source here, and we kind of need you.
Didn't we already look at them all?
So, remember how on this couch we had this thing here?
Oh yeah, the weird numbers.
Right, so that's another four.
Oh, because they're five letters. That makes perfect
exactly.
sense.
Stop, so this corresponds.
So...
Is it 3, 3, 2, 4?
This is 2, 2, 5, 2.
So here's what's weird, Wander. Look over here. Same thing, different numbers.
Yeah. Yeah, so...
But that one is
there are only three of these.
2, 4. 3, 3,
that's what's
two,
weird, there, is that they're different numbers.
So the point is there are three of these clues in the entire area. So if we go to those paintings, these correspond.
Well, yeah, I think we go, we can go left to right on the paintings. Those are the letters that we type into the password, because each painting has a five-letter
precisely,
name.
Precisely, which is why I was asking you to go up. Carl, can you
Yeah, so Keith, we need you... No, no, stop, Keith.
What?
We need you with a lantern to be up there to actually read these things off, because we can't read them.
Yeah.
They're dark.
That's why I'm going to memorize this number so I can reference it. So it's 3324... You memorize the other number so we can check it afterwards.
I was actually going to say, we can just stand here.
3324.
We can read them off whenever you want.
Can you go upstairs for the last one, please?
Snapping me.
Sorry.
Oh, it's zero.
The one inside the cabinet
is zero. So what was the other code? Couch code?
Couch code is 2252.
C. We need the one up the stairway.
A. N. E. Kane.
Okay, let me see if I can find one for that.
I want to get to one of the real places where they have these.
The arm would need a cane, wouldn't it? No.
I've always wanted to experience a room escape puzzle, like the real ones.
Stainless has one apparently.
Oh, that there is.
Yeah, we'll just go visit him in what, like, Texas? Was he the one that's in Texas? Got Kane.
Okay, got Kane. You want to go get the last one?
All right. So looking at our password. Wait, last one. Was there another set of squares?
Yeah, there's one more. Go up to the paintings. I know where it is.
Okay. So that is four.
It's 4412.
H O P probably E. Yeah, hope. It's hope.
Hope. Okay.
So we already got zero? Did you solve the zero?
Yeah, we already got zero.
That was the first one I typed
in. Pain and hope.
How the hell do you get downstairs so fast?
There we go. I just know where the stairs are. We have a way out, I think, somewhere. Where's it? Did the door open? Oh, upstairs.
Yeah, door upstairs is open. Yep, here we go.
I'm kind of disappointed that we didn't have to solve the riddles. Because we found the secret code to just
Act
getting
two,
every password.
The study parlor.
Does it freak you at all that we don't know we don't know the time limit?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, multiplayer might not have it.
Maybe.
Yeah, well, I don't think multiplayer
here,
does.
Go around flipping on all the lights, by the way.
Creepy paintings. Found a letter.
So it's a gramophone.
Dear Professor, I must confess I am amazed by your recent findings. I would never have imagined that applying specific electrical impulses could make butterflies contract and expand in this manner long after they are dead. I know this was just a side project for you, but... if you would care to share your methods with my associates at the Entomology Society, we could both benefit greatly. Would love to hear from you, Alan Rooney.
So this is an audio puzzle area. There are paintings with little chimes below them.
Yep, that one was really high-pitched, the cardinal. What was that by the window? Wait, that was practically the same. January the 11th, 1947. What did I do to deserve this?
Hello,
those were the words
paintings
that rung in my head. When I happily gave my vows to... Wait, my vows to Edmund?
It's vows to Edmund.
Vows.
Michelle, they just can't... They can't type. But now I find myself repeating those same words to myself. And the darkness has crept into the meaning of everything, just as it does in this house. I feel like a ghost. A whisper coming down the halls.
Echoing down the halls.
Echoing down the halls. We seem to be living in two separate worlds, him and I. In fact... Every day that goes by, I find myself reassuring that I still exist.
Huh.
Yeah, I honestly just think the developers aren't exactly...
Oh, wait, what's up with the butterflies? A question about it. Some of them seem to be broken or folded somehow.
It really does say
wows.
But
not in a pattern. Yeah.
So it's
look up in the corner, please. The corner.
I feel like these butterflies are somehow going to be our secret. Oh,
why
wait,
my lovely
here,
poets.
Wander, stare at the butterflies, get a full view of all of them, see if any of them react. Oh
yeah, they do.
Wow,
they
I saw
do.
That.
They open and close with the chimes?
Yeah.
That's gross.
Okay, Keith, you want to hit the chimes?
I'll
stand
go press
here.
Buttons and you say how it reacts. All right, trying this one.
Oh, it closes a lot of them.
Yeah, it closes a lot of them. You want to...
Let's try that.
Okay,
all right,
that's
back
fine.
To the room. Oh,
That's all of them. They're all
open.
Yeah, we
just got a
pop-up
saying we're good to go.
Wow.
Whoa.
Damn, that was fast.
Hey, creepy bear rug. Well, we gotta make up for us being stuck
on
the last one for so long.
I mean,
who's your spooky bear?
Oh, the bear has a note in its mouth.
Oh, weird. Are those just symbols?
So the Barug's mouth has a note. It says, as the four horsemen reached the hilltop, they gazed upon the four corners of the world and found true greatness. Four corners. Look for four something.
On the table.
Maybe. Oh, the table.
On the table, there's stuff.
Oh.
Wait. Keith. Dr. Lavender sat three spaces down.
On the professor's left side.
On the professor's left side.
Symbols.
Are we playing Clue?
Position,
on the table?
Yeah, kind of.
Positions at the
Physician
table.
Physician Todberry sat three spaces down on the professor's right side. In front of him was the crystal ball and some water. The guest that brought the hourglass was the same guest enjoying the bottle of whiskey. At the end of the table, Professor Edmund Gladsbury sat in his high chair. Lecter Bronman sat between the two other guests, facing the kitchen.
Okay.
So we gotta figure out where these people sat.
So Gladsbury was at the end of the table.
I found the four horse heads, by the way.
Chair.
Yeah.
Alright, but we're trying to figure out the table positions right now, because each of those table positions has a symbol with them.
The four horsemen at the four corners, so I made the
Physician
four horses
Todberry
face
three
four
faces
directions.
Down on the professor's white side. So one, two,
oh yeah, we gotta
three.
Figure out where,
take a look at this.
Which
take
direction.
Look. I'm trying to keep you updated on what I'm doing here. So I made them face four directions and it opened up the cabinet, which has gin and a golden star. I have six items in my inventory. I don't necessarily know how to get to my inventory, but I have six items.
So we gotta figure out which direction these horses
birdcage
are facing.
No, I changed I rotated them all in those directions just now and it opened the cabinet.
Oh.
That's what, that's what I was trying to explain to you, is that I was solving a puzzle and I wanted to update on you on it while it was happening.
Fair enough.
So I
have now
have
the murder weapon, by the way.
Yeah,
there's a pig with what in its... It's a dark crystal ball.
Yeah.
Okay, we need to find keys. The cabinet on...
No,
the,
can you please go back to the table description? Because I'm mapping it out. I need to know where everyone sat.
Let's find all the clues first, then we go back to that.
No, because...
Shell, if we do that, we're working off of...
Well, now I know that the crystal ball ended up in a pig's mouth.
I found an hourglass. Don't know if that matters.
But yes, the hourglass
here's
was
the thing,
part
Wander,
of the puzzle.
We might be able to get a lot of the puzzle done. I currently have seven items in my inventory.
How do you know where your inventory is?
But the bottom corner of my screen is covered in items I've picked up.
Oh, weird.
I don't necessarily know how to...
You picked up a knife,
You can mouse wheel through them like Counter-Strike.
I don't have anything like that.
You probably haven't picked any of them up. I have eight items now. I've just picked up the hourglass.
That's a...
Wait, how are you picking up stuff?
Clicking on them?
Weird, because I looked at the hourglass. I picked up a knife.
So now Keith's going to have to put all of those items on the symbols on the table.
Oh, there's a note
there's
here.
There's a, Yeah.
Yes,
Miss,
more about who's
Miss Leopoldine sat to the left of the professor. The golden star was carried by the Dr. Lavender. Dr. Lavender requested rum for the dinner. Feel like you are missing some clues? When the waves are unruly, one must cut the sails to make it. Oh, man. Wait.
Golden star with lavender.
Are there sails that we can cut to get more clues?
Dr. Lavender requested
like, literally?
Rum for the dinner.
Right. So as of right now, I have a lantern, water, whiskey, wine, gin, golden star, birdcage, hourglass, and compass.
Right. Also, I think we need to put them at the correct spots on the
yes,
table.
Yes, definitely.
Which is why there are those symbols. So can you please go to the first one? I was mapping out where people were sitting.
I need to get
on my notebook.
Herself.
What?
I just got the crystal ball, by the way, from that pig that you mentioned earlier. So that's in my inventory,
so
too.
I can look at shit.
I've got the rum.
I think it's because...
This is not fair.
I think it's because he was in the first seat in the sitting room.
I've got the tea. I mean, it's not... It doesn't really matter.
Oh.
It's asynchronous anywhere where you guys are gonna... asymmetrical anyway, where you guys are gonna be...
Keith, shut up. Keith?
What?
Ah, you've made it this far. Well, a simpleton would as well. But at least I am relieved you made it to this point. I guess you and I should get a bit more acquainted, since you seem so desperate to push through. But let me... Let me reassure you, you have a long way ahead of you still. A thought occurred to me while I was rebuilding this house. This has always been the Gladsbury Manor. But as I was renovating and replacing, thought hit me. How many bricks would you say I could remove, and this would still be the fabled Gladsbury Manor? Surely the entity of the house would survive a brick or two being replaced. But what if it went further? The botanical gardens have been rebuilt from the ground up before, so no doubt that doesn't make the house lose its identity. You think it would remain the Gladsbury Manor to the very point one replaced the final brick with a new one? Or would it still be intact, even though everything was replaced? I trust you know I can't hear you, me being dead and all, by the time you hear this recording. But I still want you to think about this. How much can we lose and still be ourselves? If it applies to houses, surely it applies to us as well.
Well, think about it.
No.
That was not actually useful, but it was interesting to listen to.
Okay, so can we please...
I'm going to crank the shit out of that for...
Do you guys struggle to hear that at all?
Yeah, I cranked up my volume thing.
Can you please look at the table again? I'm drawing a diagram. So there are four, and four. There are four sets of four things.
Or more specifically, it's eight. It's 6x2. There's 12 guests. And we need to put all the items in the right spots. All right, so what are our clues? I wish I could have the clue floating on the side of the screen while I walk around.
Be
well,
nice.
I know that
yeah.
Leopoldine, Miss Leopoldine, is sitting directly left of the professor
Keith,
who's
at
the end of the table.
Do you have dinner clues one, the note for it?
No. We need one.
Okay, because we should find that before. Because, Michelle, I can press space to pull these up whenever I want. That's why I wanted to find all these things first. Let's find that
note. So here's the thing, guys. I was trying to tell you this about this earlier. Look over here. Like, this is locked.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So I think the key,
I can't even interact
probably
with
need
these
to find keys
to find out if it's locked.
You can't like highlight its little knob.
Look at the knights.
Nope.
The knight is missing a hand.
When you highlight its handle, Keith. You don't get anything.
Nope. I don't get dick. I can
Weird.
Read notes. I can read notes and interact with a couple of objects.
Oh, look at the clock.
Yeah, it's saying how much time we have left.
Oh.
Oh, it actually says it somewhere.
Well, yeah. So when everything is black, then we're dead. We're a third of the way.
Yeah, we're probably doomed. It's fine. Learning curve. And also, time wasted listening to some guy ramble and as we burn.
So this was clue number two.
I think we may want to make do with the clues we have. Or at least start.
Let's try to do as much as we can with the
clues
we have.
Keith, you've got all this stuff. See if you can start puzzling it out.
I mean Shell's one with a diagram. Do you have the locations known for any of them yet, based on the clues you have?
Well, I mean, Gladsbury's sitting at the very end. Miss Leopold's supposed to be sitting directly to his left, but I don't know any of the items she was supposed to have. But if you could just, like, read off one of them, because Wander isn't letting me read them.
Did you find Gladsbury's item yet? Gladsbury.
Which one was that?
Gladsbury sits at the end in his high chair. So I'm trying to figure out anything about Gladsbury. Let's see.
Yeah, Dr. Lavender sat three places down on the right? So Lavender?
Yeah.
Oh, because the Professor Gladsbury's at the end, so the professor's left side is the back of the room. So Lavender is over here. Okay, that's a start.
You know what? I bet Gladsbury didn't have anything.
I think it's three guests, and each guest has two items.
Yeah.
I mean, six guests, and each three guests on each side.
Yes.
Okay, so Lavender's at the very end on the left.
Yeah, so very end of the left, and Lavender had rum?
Todd Berry sat three spaces
down
on the
professor's...
Okay,
so
let's
talk about...
It says physician Todd Berry has a crystal ball and water. So let's okay. I'll put those there. That's straightforward.
Okay, Lavender had rum and golden star. So three at the end, rum and golden star.
Crystal ball and water. There's the ball. Okay, you said
wait,
you,
no, I,
who
wait,
who
no,
had
Lavender
rum?
Is on the left side.
That's not yeah. That's Todbury.
That's,
Michelle,
that's the right
you're
side.
Not paying attention. Okay,
none
Keith
of us are
right.
paying attention. Doctor- all, there's so much talk.
Yeah.
The professor's there. So that's his
we
right
are
side.
Aware, Shell. We are doing it right currently. You're
that
micromanaging something.
Oh.
You're correct.
Shell, that
okay,
was Todbury.
Yeah, so
that's
that,
why it's
okay.
a crystal ball.
Oh.
So Dr.
That's
Lavender.
Why I was narrating as I was putting it down what I was doing.
Golden okay. Star and rum.
Is Lavender?
Are going to be
yes.
Lavender, which is the other opposite side of Todbury.
There we go.
Okay.
Okay.
It's four right. items down.
Okay. We gotta figure out where Leopoldine is.
Well, what she has.
So yeah, one we'll guest has out. An hourglass and the whiskey, but we don't know who it is.
At the end of the table, okay. Dr. Lecter Brownman sat between two other guests facing the kitchen.
Okay, so
he's at the second spot.
Brownman
so he's right
is
here,
right where you're currently standing. Yeah, the problem is we need another note.
We need to know what
we
Brownman
can't guess
had.
This.
Let's see.
Hello, Bear.
Oh, but I thought that Keith already read the bear note.
Well, I can't even read the bear note. Oh,
oh
there we are.
That was the four horsemen.
That's the horsemen.
I did that already.
Remember that you can crouch.
Yep.
They might have been dickish. Also, there's another one. Feel like you're missing some clues? When the waves are unruly, one must cut the sails to make it.
So there's the
this
ship.
One.
Leopoldine's
yeah,
on
so...
the left.
I should tear up the painting with the knife? Click and use the knife. You have the knife.
I can't. I know where the last clue is, Keith, but I can't do it.
What are you trying to do?
Can you give...
Come over here to this painting.
Can you use the knife, Keith?
Can you use the knife on this?
What knife?
Painting.
The painting.
No, a knife.
I picked up a knife, but it says, should I tear up this painting with the knife? Click to use knife. I'm clicking very hard.
Clearly you shouldn't have picked up the item then, because...
Oh, knife.
Knife. Oh.
Did you mouse
knife?
Wheel to
can
it?
Can you drop the knife? Oh, yeah. Wait.
Yeah. It would be nice to have a controls menu to tell us what the controls of the game are.
Well, I think I'm bugged. Remember, I can't interact with anything
anymore. I think he is bugged. The issue is, he picked up the knife, Keith, but you're the only one that can seem to interact with items.
Yeah, so...
But do you have a way to drop the knife back on the table or anything?
No, I have a knife...
But you need to use it on the painting.
Oh, unless they... Oh.
Are you using it for the controller?
Be frustrating.
I mean, I can't use T on the, on
enter,
the painting.
Space? Anything?
I think we're stuck. I don't think we can progress.
Really?
I have... Oh, wait. I have another controller plugged in. Maybe that's doing it.
Oh, do you think your controller's plugged in and it's killing your control somehow?
Oh,
well, I had them plugged in. No. Yeah, maybe.
You shouldn't. We didn't know that you shouldn't have picked up the knife.
How was I supposed to know the game was gonna break?
She just said you didn't know. That's what she said.
I know, but she's saying it in such a way that it's like
it's slightly accusatory.
Yeah, Shell does this.
You both
you
do. It's fine.
For,
is there any way you can put the knife
other.
Back on the table?
No.
Let's see.
Well, can you guys guess? Can you guys guess where they are?
I'm in the process of trying.
There's only so many spots left.
Yeah, let's see. I know the hourglass and whiskey are the
wait,
same
wait,
person.
Wait,
Keith,
what?
Pick
table,
up,
table,
pick,
go grab
pick up the knife.
Shouting.
Can you use the knife on the picture?
Die picture.
Yes, he can.
The professor had nothing to drink, nor any trinkets
nor
in front
trinkets.
Of him.
Because Lady Skirill, to the right of the professor. Skirill.
Was the knife and some tea.
Knife and...
Here, you keep going through that. I'll start putting those things down.
Okay.
The guest with the hourglass...
Here, we know where Brahmin is. Set with both the birdcage and the gin. So, middle left, birdcage, gin.
Where's the birdcage? There we go.
Okay.
That's four down.
Middle right is going to be compass and wine.
Fine.
Wait, no. Hold on. Never mind, that's wrong.
You had one that job!
Sorry, pick him back up. Madame Rose sat there, but that's not... Here's the clue specifically. Madame Rose sat next to the guest who sat to the right of the professor. In front of him was the compass and some wine.
The compass and some wine
directly
has to be...
First on the right will be compass and wine, unless they gendered the person wrong, at which point it's not my fault for getting it wrong.
So compass and wine is the first spot to the right of where the professor was sitting.
I think compass and wine is in the middle. Because the person on the right was the person you just told me. That was the last person was the person on the right.
Wait, no?
Hold on.
The person right before that was the person that you just told me. You just told Skrill.
Let me figure out.
I think
let's see. Did you
I think the gender is just wrong. Let's see.
Okay. What was Skrill again?
Hourglass and Whiskey. I haven't put those down yet, so that's
the
last one.
Oh, yeah, you're right. They gendered Madame Rose wrong.
There we go. Hourglass and Whiskey.
Yep.
I heard a chime.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, the next room awakens. Yep.
I thought it wasn't going to open.
Don't pisses me off that I literally can't interact with things.
There's a clock.
Except well, you did, which is even more confusing, because you interacted with a
thing.
Ooh,
a switch puzzle.
Hello.
Pipes.
Pipe dream.
Great. Oh, wait, don't
there's
pick
a lead
it up.
Pipe, Keith. You might be able to pick it up and use it.
Those all
well,
have
yeah,
death symbols. That's not a good sign.
No. Go to the very right, Keith. There's a lead pipe you can pick up. Maybe you can
Keith,
connect
there's
something.
A lead pipe you can probably cram in the middle of this.
I have a lead pipe, yes.
See if you can put it in that, like, empty
spot.
Doing a quick once over to see if there's any other spots, but it doesn't look like it.
Yep.
Alright.
Yep, there it is. Let's keep looking around. It's like... Nope.
So it's in the red
it
right now.
Also annoys me that he's the only one.
He's the only one that can turn.
He's
the
only one with a light. He's the only one that can interact with anything. Period. Anymore.
Let's make sure there's no blueprints on the ground.
Oh, there's definitely a slot for at least two more pipes.
Step through the light with me and spread the gas to the halls. Help me awaken the house so your fate can come true. Three steps you may take before regret sets in. Ew.
Huh.
Rather old damp newspaper dating back to what year?
1920.
What were the first newspapers?
1947. Shell, those probably aren't clues. It'd be pretty dickish.
Well, I'm writing them down.
I mean, if we ever see a four-digit number code, we know where to check.
Hey, Keith. Keith, can you interact with the lamps on the walls, by the way?
Yeah, if he could turn on the lamps.
Oh, there's one.
Yeah.
Motherfucker!
Yeah, he's...
You're the one with the lamp, and you're the only one that can turn on the lights.
He's...
This is so garbage!
The most confusing thing is that I joined your lobby.
I know, but
did.
You were the first seat.
But you're
so,
he was in the first seat.
From now on, please turn on all lamps, because apparently
I literally
I don't
didn't
have
look
arms.
Up yet, so I never saw any of them.
I'm a T-Rex person.
Yeah,
apparently.
I got a big head and little arms.
It's annoying. Or maybe I'm carrying Shell around, and that's the point.
Yeah.
The game's realist.
She's your Yoda backpack. Solving all the puzzles
like
for
me.
You.
Oh, you can move through clocks.
Funny.
I don't really see other pipes anywhere.
Oh, okay. I don't either. Can you see if you can remove that one, or mess with the handles? I'll keep looking for a pipe. In the woodwork.
Boy, look at the symbols at the top. Is it just all, like,
death?
Death
and death.
So, in other words, you do not want any of the gas. No, don't.
That was weird.
Don't.
I'm trying. I don't know how it works yet. I'm figuring.
No.
I'm trying to figure it out.
No. Stop. You do not want all three of them to light up. You don't.
Yeah, but I don't. I'm trying to figure out how it works at all. Is the problem?
Okay. So, Keith, if they're parallel to the pipe, that means there's gas going through them.
It means they're open if they're parallel. You need to make them perpendicular to stop the gas from flowing to those.
Yeah. What's also weird, though, is that you know the part where it said only three you can only have three mistakes till set three steps till regret sets in. That means only three of them can be changed.
No. That means those three will light up and we die.
No. It all. No, only three of them. Wait, have you interacted with it at all yet?
I can't.
So then yes, only three can be changed because they were changing when after me. I would change a few, and then after a three, the old one would that I did longest ago changed back.
Okay. Well, can you seal it up in such Let's a way see. That one will at least be closed? Well, there is one closed right now.
Yeah, we need to get gas to the gas meter down Uh-oh. The bottom.
Oh, we got it.
Wait, what?
I win.
Wait, you heard a chime?
Yep. Turns out making them light up was good. Oh, did I just leave you behind and you didn't come in?
Yes.
Where are you?
Did you go down?
He went through the door?
Did the door just close behind you?
Well, oh, no. We can't.
Can
you open the. Wait, so because you passed through the door, we're left behind.
Yeah, you just disappeared on us, Keith?
Yeah, you ran down the hall and disappeared.
Stuck here.
That's not good.
So. If Keith already solved the puzzle, then what can we do?
Nothing. We are stuck here. But we've been broken this entire time.
I wonder if you switch the valve. Wait, you can't interact with the valves, can you?
Shell, I can do nothing. I can walk. I can read notes.
And we
are alone.
Do we need to start over?
Do you guys want to start over?
I kind of want to give
sure
it. They've been patching it every day.
This game's randomly generated. We could just start over and it'll do different puzzles anyway.
I just kind of want to play Looter Kings.
But
because
this game's I'm enjoying this. And
this
I don't know
true.
If I'll enjoy that at all.
But the problem is
I've been stuck here. Okay. I'm gonna reset the game. Oh wow, the game pause screen is
Random pause related
yeah,
stuff
weird.
Goes here. You know, saving, settings, quit, and such.
Yeah, it's
There's
weird.
There's not much.
There's, okay. There isn't a pause screen properly, which is really bizarre.
Okay, I'm gonna quit to main menu. I'm gonna quit the game. We're gonna try that again.
Oh, this room's the same.
Oh, this one has cigars. Well, same, yeah. It's gonna be the same setup, but the clues and the puzzles
are the clues gonna be different?
Clue 2. 10 fish I caught without an eye, 9 without a tail. Half of 8 and 6 missing heads landed in my pit. That's the same code,
the same.
I think.
Oh, yeah. I did not have the ability to open up
doors?
Cabinets. So, Keith,
do you think it happened because of the controller?
Did you get the light again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Motherfuck.
Mostly spite. Yay. So, do you think it was because of the controller problem?
Maybe. Yeah, because it does have controller support. It still pisses me off that,
Whoa, that's a different...
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's randomly generated, but the puzzle is still the same. So, actually, the placement's still the same, too.
Oh, the
Keep
couch
going
is
to the
gone.
Paintings.
The couch is gone.
Yeah, the couch is gone, but the clues are still there.
Let me make sure that the clues are the same, because this is a 2, 2, 3, 5.
So
yes.
Wait.
So the number clue was the same earlier, but I found one that's actually different. Clue for one says, I am here to make you feel my presence is often unreal. Why the long face? Why the frustration? After all, I am only sensation. You and my body went separate ways. I fill out the empty space. So clue one is a different password.
Oh, yeah. All the passwords are the same, but, like, the solution, the way we go about solving this...
Wait, is that,
is
like,
the same.
Soul or something? Mind or soul? That's my guess for that one.
Yeah, or we could just do the square thing and just zip through it.
Yeah, so we're finding the squares. I wrote down it's 2, 2, 3, 5 for one of them.
I went ahead and typed in 0 for the elf again.
Oh, was that...
Was it the same?
Yeah, the same. It had the same number clue about the fish, and it was 0 last time.
You know what? It makes sense, though, because the statue didn't change. Whereas, this one's going to be the same as last time, too.
Yep, I just found the telephone pad one for 2 also. So, yeah, that was it was definitely 0
that
again.
That doesn't have cane.
Damn it. What was the naked guy one the last time?
Hope?
Wow, so
or
another clue for number
whatever.
1. There's only one force humanity would avoid
different.
At all cost. One invisible and one and quite invincible, but it would leave you the second it killed you. Huh. I keep wanting to...
I got Adam.
Adam.
I literally guessed it. I'm... Whoops.
For what?
That one on the right, I just kept flipping and I got it because I was just trying to see what letters were available.
I don't even have clues for three yet.
Yeah, Steve, it's this one over here. How lucky he was. He knew when he said a good thing, nobody had said it before.
Oh, because he was the first
Adam.
Man.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Okay. In that case, do we want to just do... Do we want to do the square puzzle for the last one, Keith?
Well, I mean, I want to figure out this one. It's got a weird melting person over here, and it's got the two weird clues we've heard so far. So, there is only one force humanity would avoid at all cost. One invisible and quite invincible, but it will leave you the second it killed you. I am here to make you feel. My presence is often unreal. Why the long face? Why the frustration? After all, I am only a sensation. You and my body went separate ways. I fill out the empty space. And that's one over in the corner over here.
If it's four, my guess would be time, soul, or mind.
Oh, let's try mind. That sounds great. There's no N for slot three. It is not correct.
No.
time is also seems fitting enough. There's no T.
Okay.
Please don't type random letters until it wins. I do want to solve it and not just keep pressing random stuff.
I just want to see what letters are available so I have,
this sounds
clues.
Super dangerous. You're totally going to solve it on accident again.
Okay, so it can start with H, M, J, P, U.
I fill out the empty space. You and my body went separate ways. Why the long face?
Is
no.
Nope, it's not.
Yeah.
A force that humanity would avoid at all cost. Hang on a second. No, that's wrong. There's no first letters. So we have J, P, H, M, J.
Pain.
It was pain.
Oh, man.
That makes perfect
you
sense.
You can't just blame me for that one.
You did it, though, didn't you? You totally just... It just we got that accident.
We were both flipping
letters
to see what was available.
No. Did he get in? Oh, he
actually,
got in.
He just warped through the door.
Oh.
I wonder if
this is pretty, though.
The door closed right behind me, so maybe it always goes after me. But we should stick together, though.
The door closed behind me, too. Yeah,
we need to stick together.
We've got a new room, though. Yeah, you did immediately do what I did last time after we just talked about not doing that.
That's a good point. Though, honestly, I think it was only an issue because I had become a non-player somehow.
Let's read the note at the desk.
Okay. At this desk, I steer my life through letters and contracts. I always believed I could steer in any direction that I desired, but I soon discovered that fate had other plans for me, and I was nowhere near being the captain of the world around me. Some claim that my state of mind is simply because I have turned my back on the world. But looking back, I don't feel it was worth paying attention to. I dream back the days when I aided my countrymen during the war with my scientific studies. They saw me as a magician, but sadly never understood that true science overcomes any hocus pocus. My former friends think me a recluse, a hermit, cut off from his surroundings. They do not understand that only in solitude can one seek perfection.
Now, world, magician, and... hermit were the only things capitalized
out of turn.
Okay, so you've
got
just one thing real quick. This deer has anime eyes.
I want to say
that's why I was laughing.
It is an anime.
The deer has anime eyes.
It is. They're creepy people eyes at the very
least. They're like drawn on, like painted on eyes in an otherwise 3D like furry model thing.
Are you getting frame rate issues with this game, by the way?
Not even a little bit.
My frame rate is awful.
Weird.
For this game sometimes. Yeah. It's like truly bad.
Okay, what's in there? A book? Untrodden Peaks, Unfrequented Valley.
It's nothing useful.
Unless we pick up books or something.
I have an idea.
No, I don't think we can.
I bet it's Skype.
A lot of locked terminals. Oh, you have Skype open? Doesn't that just randomly mess with everything?
Yeah, you're right. It's feeling better.
Okay, guys. Wait, now you can open doors?
No.
Oh, I found the hermit.
Oh. Yeah, you did find the hermit? Where?
Right here, in this case up here. It's just in this case, the card, the hermit, from like a tarot card.
Yeah. Right, right. So I had the world, the magician, and the hermit.
Let's see.
We're in the letter. Are those the three things on the table? Look at the table, please.
Those are keyholes.
Yeah, also this this plant is floating.
Wait. Hold on.
This plant over here is floating.
Oh yeah, you're right.
So there's nothing you could do to the hermit box?
No.
Can you look at it closer?
Oh, I can.
You can flip them. Wait, what does it change?
Was that... No, that was...
That's me. What? That's me.
Keith. Yeah, what are you doing?
Oh, he's steering the the wheel.
It said it was stuck.
This rotates the cards.
How are you steering the wheel? It says it's stuck. Maybe I forgot to do something.
I'm just mouse wheeling and moving my mouse. I'm just clicking on it and moving my mouse, and I can rotate it to make this card
change. It's saying to me that it's stuck. What?
Well... So what happens when you flip the cards? Can we please look at the cards?
Let's see.
Okay, Keith, can you go spin the wheel, I guess?
Justice.
Go spin the wheel. I can't interact with it.
Yeah, okay. Justice is not one of them.
Go slowly. There's Magician.
That's the Magician.
There's Hermit.
That's the Hermit. Wait, they have numbers associated with them.
Do
and
they?
The world.
The world is 21. 21.
Hermit is...
Did you get the number?
Okay.
Yep. And we need Magician, which is 1.
Magician is 1.
1, 9, 21.
So those were all the things mentioned in the letter.
Right, because that it mentioned the world first, Magician second, and the Hermit third.
Huh. And we have three keyholes somehow?
You can move the chair?
Yes.
Is there anything under it or in it? Or
doesn't look like it, but I can mess up this room. I can... Hey, Keith, turn around.
What's up?
Lifting lifting chairs, funny. Yeah,
I think we're talking about something entirely client-side right now.
You can't see me,
lifting the chair.
Handing this couch around?
No. I don't see a couch, actually.
Well, it's like a chair couch thing. Like a muffin chair.
Oh, the stool? Is that the word you're looking for?
There's two chairs. There are two chairs.
For me, there's one stool in the entire room and no other furniture besides.
I mean, the moment I picked these up, they probably disappeared
they
from
disappeared
your session.
From him.
Because I couldn't deal with the physics objects sinking.
Weird.
We didn't read this note over here yet, did we? About the cleaning aid?
It was just a letter.
Yeah.
Wait, about the what?
Let's see. We are writing you to inform you of that your cleaning aide, Mrs. Rosalie, will no longer be visiting you. We understand that you had a loud verbal conflict with her that took about above an hour about her deranged notions of tidiness. She has explained that her reaction was caused by her accidentally leaving a drawer and some cupboard doors not fully shut during cleaning. Our girls do the best to clean the residence of our clients, but we simply cannot accept this level of reaction on such minor inconsistencies. That we no longer be offering you any service. It's just, he went off on a cleaning lady. Because he's all type A about his drawers.
So, let's look in the drawers.
That's the drawer.
We're all out of
them. Those are locked.
We don't have notes, so... This is,
By the way, was there a chair behind the steering wheel? Originally, when you came in the room?
No.
Huh. So all furniture is only...
For you?
For me.
Well, there's a stool in the middle of the room, for me.
No, okay, so there's that, but that's not a physics object that can be moved.
Weird.
Okay, guys, we need to find these keys. What's in the glass?
Nothing.
Anything?
Wait.
A dirty golden key.
Brass, iron, gold. Could it have to do with the atomic number of gold? Trying to think of the periodic table, if any of these numbers match up with gold, if we have to rearrange these two things in order. These three things in order. I can't pick them up, though.
Rearrange what?
So do we need keys?
Well, they're keyholes. You can't pick up keyholes, man.
Well, I thought that they were supposed to fit to something, and not necessarily that they were just... But yeah, they are totally just... they're just stationary.
We need keys to go in the keyhole.
I'm just trying to find the puzzle, because so far I've always known what the puzzle was, but right now I don't even know what I'm trying to do.
I think we need to open up the desk, which means
we
need keys,
but I mean, the mechanic of the puzzle is lost on me right now.
I mean, currently you can interact with the wheel, and I can't.
Well, so is there anything else that changes in the room when the cards are flipped around?
Let's see.
Keith, you want to spin the wheel?
So the order again is World, Magician, Hermit. I wonder if we're supposed to just go to those three pages in that order. It says it's stuck.
Oh.
Now I can't.
What did we do ahead of time that made it unstuck? Maybe I forgot to do something. What was that about steering in the letter?
Did the light on the other side of the room just turn off for you guys? Oh, or was that this guy?
He turned it off.
Turn off all the lights! Haha! I'll put away my lantern. And then the answer will glow in front of us. It did not glow in front of us. Oh god, it really gets dark in here. Okay. According to chat, gold is 79 and iron is 26. And of course, yeah, brass is not an element. So those are not the numbers we got a second ago at all, are they?
No. Here, can you look at the...
There's nothing on the underside of the drawer.
We have
the two notes. Can you press any of the keys on the typewriter?
Can you please look at the posters?
Okay, typewriter is nothing. Painting is very cartoony.
It's like Alice in Wonderland.
I just don't really see stuff I can interact with,
What's the statue holding, or is there anything you can get from
it? It's too high. We are midget people.
Well, can you look? Carter the Great. I have a hard time believing the professor believed in magic, but the old posters have a charm.
I'm just wondering why it went from working to not working for me.
Keith, I'm going to zoom in on the magician again. See if you can interact with the wheel while I'm staring at it.
Nope. It's also a single-player game, potentially.
What did we do to
allow him to... I don't know, I feel like this game isn't finished.
Let's see.
Or maybe it broke on you again?
I think it broke on us again. I think whatever we forgot to do...
Turn my back to the world. Is there a world here?
No globe that I can see.
Wait, do we inspect the paintings in order?
First
you turn your back to the world, then there's something about war and scientific studies, and then there's the hermit.
Well, we need to get the hermit up on the screen.
We can't do that.
Wait, but how did we?
So there's the magician.
Because Keith could...
Turn off... I'm going to try turning off the lights by the... Oh, there's not a light by this painting. Crap. I was like, what if I turn on the lights by the paintings in that order? Oh, wait, there's a light over a bookcase. Is that the scientific studies? Maybe? So, world, studies,
using lights,
magician, maybe,
it's world, magician, hermit.
Oh, shit.
So.
Solitude. I think the lights are the clues. Is the...
First of all, you're accomplishing nothing.
The only thing I can interact with. There's also no light with the hermit.
I steered my life through letters and contracts, always believing I could steer in any direction I desired, but I soon discovered that fate had other plans for me, and I was nowhere near being the captain of the world around me. So the captain seems to refer to the wheel. So we have the wheel, or maybe that's also just referring to this painting of the...
Can you only steer when the light isn't at the table?
No, it was definitely there before. Let's see. What's confusing is at one point, I think one of us could do the one of us could use the table and the other one couldn't.
Yeah, Keith could steer. But nobody else could.
This might just be broken. Let's see.
I mean, we've already run into some...
It was really cool when you could move them, but...
Turn your back on the world.
We were looking at World Magician Hermit. Wait, where was that last lamp? You don't want the lamp above the old man with the... Oh.
Do I have anything in my inventory? No, I don't.
I mean, is the world the deer instead of the...
This is bizarre.
This is... not great. Maybe the lights are the puzzle. Yeah.
I mean, it'd be weird if the lights were the puzzle.
No, they have to be the puzzle. It's the only thing we can interact with in the room.
Right.
I just need to figure out the sequence here.
But the problem is we need the hermit on display.
Okay, let's say... now. Right now it says magician. So what if we turned off every light except for the magician?
Oh, good point.
Oh, I see. Now can you steer?
Nope.
No. Can Keith steer?
Nope. See, is this the only light left in the room? Yes, it is.
Yes.
Let's see. Maybe it's suddenly unlocked? No?
Yep,
wait,
it is.
It is.
It is.
What? What? Oh,
turn
the wheel?
Turn your back on. Yeah.
Yeah, the wheel.
Turn your lantern back on, by the way. You're fine. The wheel's unlocked.
You move the wheel?
The wheel's unlocked because it's only the light by the magician that's working.
The tower. The hermit.
Okay.
The hermit looks like it's just this guy over here. Who doesn't have his own light.
Do we want to try...
We tried turning both on.
Ones? Yep.
No, maybe not.
No, it's still turning here if you turn on that bookshelf.
Let's see. I mean, I figure we try to solve one of them, right? So let's try to go to, what was the other ones? The world? Is the world one of them?
Yeah, the world.
Rotate it. Tower. Magician. Oh. Hermit. What's weird to me is magician's still an option on here. There's the world. It's a lady? Let's see.
I mean, it's probably this painting.
Painting of the ocean?
Here's the thing. The reason why I don't think we're solving anything is that nothing's chiming.
Yeah.
Key.
My former friend's... Wait, where's the key?
I got a brass key from the magician just now. It was in the cupboard.
Oh.
Okay, there we go.
Okay.
What? But now we need a silver and a gold key.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which would have to come from the hermit in the world. Do you have to check that drawer again and again?
Maybe. This is about as obtuse as it goes, doesn't it? I'll try closing it.
Well, what's the marker now?
Right
what's the
now,
what's the card?
We have the justice, which I don't think is any of the things.
Oh, we don't want justice.
There's the hermit.
Okay, so can you find the old man? Like turn the light on near the old man? That's the magician one.
No, I turned off both. This is the old man. Between these two is why I turned them on.
Well,
if it impacted at all.
Nope.
Wait, so you had found the key in the drawer?
Yeah, it was in the drawer.
Well, turn off the magician light. Did anyone turn off the magician light?
Oh, weird. The book's back.
Yeah.
Right.
And whoa, did you just take it? No, wait, what? Whoa.
What? Whoa, so... It changes what's
in the
drawer.
The book changed.
It changes what's in the drawer.
So what's now? What?
It's nothing.
Nothing?
Let's see.
Okay.
Tell me if you see anything.
Yeah.
Was there a key?
Okay, so the book's back. What's the card? So when the hermit comes up, this book turns into, this book shows up when you bring the hermit up for some reason.
And what does the book say?
It's just that Untrodden Peaks and Unfrequent Valleys by Amelia B. Edwards is the book that was here in the first place.
Here, turn off the bookcase light, turn on a different light in the room. Let's try it.
The deer?
Yeah, let's try the deer.
It's still the book.
Still the book?
Yeah, no, I mean, no, it's gone now. There's nothing here. It's just the book comes in every now and then, probably when you get to that one card over and over again.
Okay, so let's try the wave picture.
Captain the world around me. Let's see. Nothing in the drawer.
Here.
You have to close the drawer?
Are you trying to close it? We're both holding it. It does not go well.
Well, the thing is, the muck book.
Whoa.
Huh? You can open that now.
Those were locked.
What's inside?
Nothing.
Yeah, that was
locked. Let's spin it. Go spin it.
Okay. It's locked. It's currently locked.
Maybe we have to close the drawer now.
Nope.
Maybe we have to check this cupboard for the next thing. I'm not sure. I'll close the cupboard again, just in case it's a problem. But maybe that's where we need to find the next key when we figure out what's next.
What's the symbol on the
says the tower
thing now? The tower. So what was the tower?
I can no longer interact with the wheel.
How does this puzzle? I can though. Whoa! Did you turn the light on?
Hmm? Yeah, I did for a second.
Okay, I thought the wheel did that for a second. See, what one should I be trying to turn to?
Did we already get the magician then?
I think so.
For the key.
We've gotten one thing so far, this puzzle is so obtuse that our solution could easily be confirmation bias. As far as what we think we solved. Like, why would the brass be magician? I don't even know. Hermit.
There's the book's book back. Again.
The book came back? Yeah. Are these locked again? They're not locked still.
Well, wait, is there a spot on the bookshelf where it should have gone?
Wait. It's locked for me.
Is it?
Oh, and now
yeah,
you,
it's locked for me. I can't do anything with it.
Huh.
I don't know, guys.
Is there?
I think we need to wait for a patch or several.
Is there an empty book on the bookshelf?
I'm just so excited about this game, and I'm really mad that it doesn't seem to be working.
I like the idea of it, but this is definitely one of those where it needs to be a lot clearer. But what the hell's going on? Because yeah, I can't even interact with the wheel. But you.
Well, who's up there now? The hermit?
It doesn't matter.
Didn't you have to turn both lights on by the hermit?
So what's going on right now is something that I kind of liken to what happened when I played Final Fantasy Type-0, and the game threw a few too many, like, battles you're meant to lose or battles you're meant to run away from into the middle of the story, and it broke my trust in all following battles for the rest of the game of whether or not I was supposed to actually win any boss fight for the rest of the game. The issue here is that now the game's broken a few times, I can't trust that anything's working. And so now it's... we can't tell what's going on because stuff seems to be breaking.
All I know is that the key magically appeared when Carl, when you had the magician card displaying with the light above.
Yeah, that was obvious, but there's no feedback. Like, that was the most obvious of all of them.
Here's the biggest reason why I'm thinking of calling it Shell, is that different stuff happens between my game and your guys' game.
Yeah, like, the wheel is locked for me when it isn't for Keith.
But also, sometimes it works for both of us, I think.
Yeah.
So, like, the game's just flat out not working correctly, which makes me wonder if any of the puzzles trigger correctly, and if any of, this whole room could be broken for all I know, unfortunately.
I honestly gave up in this room the moment I realized that the couches weren't synced across both of us.
Yeah, I don't have a couch.
I have these three couchy chairs.
Well,
and you can't
maybe we'll
see
come
them.
Back someday. Because I really want this game to be good, but it needs to have proofreading and playtesting. And maybe a little design... playtesting for both design reasons and for bug reasons.
I wonder if the single-player version is smoother or...
Probably, because it doesn't have to sync information
across
both. It could
be. I might try it later on my own just to see how it goes.
Yeah. Sounds fun.
Mm-hmm.
Although we might do the same.
I will say I kind of hate this room, though. It's this is the one room that's especially obtuse.